Module 3, Section 8.7, Graphs of the Other Circular Functions. First, we'll look at the graphs of cosecant and secant functions. Cosecant values are reciprocals of the corresponding sine values. If the sine of x is equal to 1, the value of cosecant of x is 1. Similarly, if sine of x is equal to negative 1, then cosecant of x is equal to negative 1, since the reciprocal of 1 and negative 1 is simply itself. But when sine is between 0 and 1, then the cosecant of x will be greater than 1. And similarly, if sine is between negative 1 and 0, then cosecant of x will be less than negative 1. So let's look at a couple of examples. Since we know that the sine of x is equal to 1 over the cosecant of x, if we let the sine of x be equal to the value of 1/2, so that would be this example, between 0 and 1. So then we have that 1/2 is then equal to 1 over the cosecant of x. And if we work this out, then we see that the cosecant of x is equal to 2. So cosecant is greater than 1. Now let's also look at our second situation here. Let's say that the sine of x is equal to negative 5/8. Then we have that negative 5/8 is equal to 1 over the cosecant of x. And when we work this out, we will get a value of cosecant of x equal to negative 8/5, which is smaller than negative 1. When the absolute value of the sine of x approaches 0, the cosecant of x absolute value gets larger. The graph of y equal cosecant x approaches the vertical line x equals 0. In fact, the vertical asymptotes are the lines x equal n times pi, or any multiple of pi. So when we want to sketch traditional graphs of cosecant and secant, the first thing we need to do is graph the corresponding reciprocal function as a guide. We call it our guide function. So to graph y equal cosecant, we will use sine as a guide. To graph secant, we'll use cosine as a guide. Secondly, sketch the vertical asymptotes, which we'll see when we examine the graphs. They will have equations of the form x equal k, where k is an x-intercept of the guide function. Thirdly, sketch the graph of the desired function by drawing the U-shaped branches between adjacent asymptotes. So first, let's look specifically at the graph of the cosecant function. Notice that it is discontinuous at values of x of the form x equal n times pi, and has vertical asymptotes at these values. Those are drawn by dashed lines here, our vertical lines where our graph will be undefined. There are no x-intercepts. You see that our pink dotted line here is our guide function, or y equals sine of x. And we've drawn our U-shaped, which the solid blue line, is the graph of cosecant. So notice that it will never cross the x-axis. Its period is 2 pi, but it has no amplitude. Notice that the amplitude was how high or low our original function got, but the cosecant function will go on forever to positive infinity and forever to negative infinity. Also, cosecant is symmetric with respect to the origin and is an odd function. Now let's look at the secant function. Notice our guide function is cosine and it's been graphed. We have our vertical asymptotes in place and we've drawn our U-shaped branches between those asymptotes. Remember that the secant and cosecant functions technically won't have this dotted line on when you finally do your final graph. You would do the dotted line just as a guide and then erase that. the U-shaped branches are the graph of cosecant and secant. So the secant function is discontinuous at values of x of the form 2n plus 1 times pi over 2, and has vertical asymptotes at these values. Notice the vertical asymptotes are occurring at the x-intercepts of our guide function. Also, secant has no x-intercepts. Its period is 2 pi with no amplitude, and it's symmetric with respect to the y-axis and is an even function. So let's do an example where we'll graph a secant function. Here we want to graph y equals 2 secant of 1 half x. Our guide function for secant will be its reciprocal, which is cosine, so we will be looking at first graphing y equal 2 cosine of 1 half x. The period will be found similarly the way we found the period for cosine, which was 2 pi over b, or in this case, 2 pi over 1 half, which will give us a period of 0 to 4 pi. Another way we could do that is to find the interval that satisfies our inequality between 0 and 2 pi of what we're taking the cosine of, 1 half x. So to solve this inequality, we would multiply all three parts by 2 to clear out our fraction here. And we'll end up with a value of x between 0 and 4 pi. Dividing this interval into 4 equal parts gives the key points. These points are joined with a smooth dashed curve. Next, we'll sketch the vertical asymptotes where the guide function equals 0 and draw the U-shaped branches approaching the asymptotes. So we've drawn our cosine function. We didn't spend too much time showing how to do that since we did that in the last section. But once we've drawn it, then we want to draw our asymptotes at every x-intercept. This last step is to draw the U-shaped branches between, so it'll be at our peaks of our guide function, which in this case would be the maximum and the minimums here, and we draw them. Now you notice that over here, since we didn't draw our last asymptote over here, we only have half of our U shape. And technically you would erase the guide function once you've drawn your U shapes. Now let's look at the graphs of tangent and cotangent. For the tangent function, we see it graphed here. Its period is pi, and it has no amplitude. Its values are 0 when sine values are 0, and undefined when cosine values are 0. Because remember that tangent of x was y over x, where y is our sine of x, or our sine value, and x is our cosine value. So if cosine is 0, we're dividing by 0, and this is then undefined. If sine is 0, we have 0 divided by anything is 0 itself. As x goes from negative pi over 2 to positive pi over 2, tangent values go from negative infinity to positive infinity and increase throughout the interval. The x-intercepts are of the form x equals n times pi. Now let's look at cotangent. Here we see it graphed. Remember that cotangent is the reciprocal of tangent, so we're going backwards, the opposite way of our tangent graph. Its period is also pi, and it has no amplitude. Its values are 0 when cosine values are 0, and undefined when sine values are 0. You'll see this is the opposite of what we had when we were looking at our tangent function. As x goes from 0 to pi, cotangent values go from infinity to negative infinity, so we're decreasing, and it decreases throughout the entire interval. The x-intercepts are of the form x equals 2n plus 1 times pi over 2. So when we want to sketch the traditional graphs of tangent and cotangent functions, first thing is to find the period. Notice that our period is pi over b instead of 2 pi over b. This is only for tangent and cotangent. The next step here would be to locate our vertical asymptotes, and we'll solve the following equations for x. For our tangent function, we let b of x be equal to negative pi over 2 and pi over 2. For cotangent, we let b of x be equal to 0 and pi. The second step is to sketch the asymptotes we found in step 1. Thirdly, we'll divide the interval formed by the vertical asymptotes into 4 equal parts. Next, we want to evaluate the function for the first quarter point, the midpoint, and the third quarter point using the values found from step 3. Fifthly, we'll join our points with a smooth curve approaching the vertical asymptotes. So let's do an example. Here we want to graph y equals 1/2 cotangent of 2x. The period is pi over b, and in this case b is 2, so our period is pi over 2. So that means we have an interval from 0 to pi over 2 for our function. Since the function involves cotangent, we can locate our two adjacent asymptotes by solving the equations 2x equals 0 and 2x equals pi. To solve them, we'll divide by 2 on both sides, and we see that we have x equal to 0 and x equal to pi over 2 as our two vertical asymptotes. The endpoints are 0 to pi over 2, and we want to divide that interval into 4 equal parts. To do that, we take the midpoint of our original interval and find that it's pi over 4. This divides it into 2 equal intervals. We want to find the midpoint of both of those, and we get pi over 8 and 3 pi over 8. Next, we want to evaluate our function at these values. So we see we have 0 and pi over 2 as our endpoints. Pi over 4 was our middle number, and then we divided that and got pi over 8 and 3 pi over 8. Now, when we plug these values into our function for x, let's look at what happens. We'll pull up the calculator. And let's plug in our equation. We have 1/2 cotangent, which is 1 over tangent of 2x. Now, we want to find the values in our table. So one way to do that is to change our table a little bit. So I'm going to do secant and window. And I'm going to change my table to where the independent variable says ask. So I arrow over and hit enter, and then simply clear the screen. Now we'll press second graph in order to see our table, and you should see that it's blank. So we can begin entering our values here. We'll type in 0, which remember was one of our vertical asymptotes, and we should get an error. Now we'll type in pi over 8, and it evaluates our function at that value. So we get 1/2. Now let's plug in pi over 4. Notice that we get an error here. Now this is not an asymptote. Remember that this is where the cotangent function will be 0. But since we've had to use tangent, we have 1 over tangent of that. So we're dividing 1 divided by 0, which will give us an error or an undefined. So just be really careful when you're using cotangent to remember that your middle value will be 0. Now let's plug in 3 pi over 8. You see you get negative 1/2. And then we'll plug in pi over 2, and we should get an error as well since this is our other vertical asymptote. So here we're undefined, as we are here, since these are our asymptotes. And we had 1/2 and negative 1/2. And this, remember, is 0. So here we have our graph of our function. Let's look at what happens when we try to graph this on our calculator. When I hit graph on our standard window, you see that we have this funky looking function here. Let's change our window so that we have two periods. So we'll go from negative pi over 2 to positive pi over 2. And we want to go by a scale of pi over 8, since that's our first interval here. And we'll have our y min be negative 2, and we'll go to positive 2, and we still want to go by a scale of 1. Now this is beginning to look a little bit better, only notice that now your calculator is drawing these solid lines over here. One way to prevent it from doing that, press y equals. Where we have our function in here, arrow back to this slanted line in front of y1. Hit enter so that we can change what line we're going to have graphed. You want to keep going until you have the three dotted lines. Now hit graph, and what it does is it's graphing a bunch of points and not connecting them. This is going to be a more accurate graph.